Here we'll be discussing about the secondary growth. Secondary growth in case of extrastellar region. Now we have seen how exactly the secondary growth took place in intrastellar region. Intrastellar region is the if you are going to consider this image as a rough sketch of a dicot stem, what we have is the uppermost layer as epidermis followed by hypodermis and the cortical region. Inner to cortical region we have this endodermis. This endodermis is going to differentiate between the stellar and extrastellar region, that is intrastellar and extrastellar region. The region just below the endodermis, that is what we have, is pericycle, vascular bundle and pith. All together is going to constitute what is called as an intrastellar region. And the region just above the endodermis, we have the cortex, hypodermis and epidermis. Together these constitute the extrastellar region. So we are going to see the secondary growth in extrastellar region. We have the outermost layer as epidermis followed by hypodermis. Inner to hypodermis what we have, the cortical region. Usually the cortical region are made up of the parenchymatous cells, loosely arranged parenchymatous cells. Now if you are going to consider this single layer of the cortical region, it is going to de-differentiate in the sense, now these are the parenchymatous cells which form together the cortex, but these cells have the ability to divide and form some other cells or some other tissue. That process is called as de-differentiation. That is, these cells having the ability to divide and re-divide to form some other cells and tissue, that process is called as de-differentiation. Now the parenchymatous cells of the cortical region de-differentiate. We are going to take only the example of this single layer. The cells in this layer are going to de-differentiate and form what is called as meristematic cells. Now these meristematic cells have the ability to form secondary growth. How exactly? This is what we are going to see. This layer, it de-differentiated and form a meristematic cells. These meristematic cells together are going to develop a layer called as cork cambium. So this layer is developed by the meristematic cells. These meristematic cells are resulted because the de-differentiation of these parenchymatous cells present in the cortical region. So what we form is the cork cambium. Okay, this central region is cork cambium. This cork cambium is going to divide inwardly as well as outwardly. It is going to divide inwardly and outwardly. This outward and inward growth is nothing but a secondary growth in the extrastellar region. Clear, right? Now this cork cambium is going to divide first outwardly and it leads to development of these loosely arranged parenchymatous cells. That's it. It divide outwardly and form a layer, two to three layers of the loosely arranged parenchymatous layer. Now after the formation of these layers, there is a deposition outside the walls of these parenchymatous cells. Not all the cells, but some of the cells get deposited. Deposited with what? Deposited with a substance called as suberin. So suberin will be deposited on the outer wall of these parenchymatous cells. Wherever the suberin is deposited, such cells, they are going to appear as thick cells. And these cells are dead cells. Why they are dead now? Because of the deposition of the suberin, these cells are impervious or impermeable to water. It is impermeable to water, it is impermeable to nutrient, and it is also impermeable to gases. That's the reason these cells will be dead cells, and they are going to provide or going to act as a mechanical strength to the stem. So besides these, we have these loosely arranged parenchymatous cell which won't have the deposition of suberin, so they are alive still. Exchange of the gases as well as supply of the nutrient as well as water is carried in these cells, except these where the deposition of suberin is there. So this is the outgrowth of the cork cambium. Outward growth of the cork cambium. So inwardly this cork cambium is going to divide and produce layers of the parenchymatous cells. These layer is called as secondary cortex. So inwardly there is a formation of a secondary cortex by the cork cambium. This secondary cortex has got a name as phelloderm. whereas the another name for cork cambium is phellogen. Another name for this cork is called as phellum. Now what is cork? We got cork cambium from the outermost layer where there is a deposition of suberin in some of the cells. This is called as cork. Another name for cork is phellum. Another name for cork cambium is phellogen. Inward of the cork cambium is the formation of the secondary cortex. Another name for secondary cortex is phelloderm. So the phelloderm, phellogen and phellum together they are called as periderm. Together they are called as periderm. Now inner to the secondary cortex what we have? So this layer differentiated and form only this layer form this entire structure. So inner to this layer we have still these layers. This is nothing but primary cortex. Some of the layers of the primary cortex. Outward to this one we have hypodermis. Outer to hypodermis we have epidermis. So inner to this primary cortex, this is primary cortex. So inner to the primary cortex we have the endodermis. Inner to the endodermis we have pericycle. Inner to the pericycle we have vascular bundle and at the center we have pith. So this will be the entire structure of the secondary growth in case of extrastellar region. Now what all changes took place in the secondary growth is looking at this flow. This is primary growth. So what we had in primary growth, outermost epidermis, inner to epidermis we have hypodermis, inner to hypodermis we have cortex. Cortex, inner to this endodermis, endodermis, inner to endodermis is pericycle, inner to pericycle we have a cambium, inner to cambium we have primary is hilum and phloem, and inner to that is pith. What all changes occurred in the secondary growth? If you are going to list out, it will be somewhat like this. We have the epidermal region. We have the hypodermis. Inner to epidermis, what we have is hypodermis. Inner to hypodermis is this one. Inner to the hypodermis where there will be a cortical region. So we have this primary cortex. Inner to primary cortex we have this de-differentiated layer which we are going to call it de-differentiate and form what is called as meristematic cells. These meristematic cells are going to form what is called as cork cambium. So we have this cork cambium is going to differentiate and form a layer outward to this one nothing but a cork, and inward to this is secondary cortex. So next to primary cortex what we have cork. Inner to the cork cambium, inner to that is secondary cortex. So we have this secondary cortex. Inner to secondary cortex is the primary cortex. So we have primary cortex. Inner to the primary cortex we have endodermis. Inner to endodermis pericycle. We have seen secondary growth in intrastellar region. So inner to the pericycle what we have is primary phloem. Inner to the primary phloem we have secondary phloem. Inner to the secondary phloem we have cambium. Inner to cambium secondary xylem followed by primary xylem and pith. So this is the entire structures what we is going to form in the secondary growth of both extra as well as intrastellar regions. If the secondary growth is going to continue, there is a complete absence of the pith. Why? Because the primary xylem will invade the central region and the pith is going to be crushed. So exactly what we are going to have is primary xylem in the center. In the same way, as we all know that deposition of suberin on these cells. What is the quality of these cells? They are impermeable to water, nutrient as well as gases, right? So above this cork, what we have? We have hypodermis, we have epidermis, we have primary cortex, right? If these cells are going to stop the supplement of nutrient, water and gases, etc. So these cells, they are devoid of all these things. They are devoid of water, they are devoid of nutrients, they are devoid of gases. As a result, they are going to die off. All hypodermis is going to vanish, epidermis is going to vanish, and even the primary cortex is going to be destroyed completely. So if the secondary growth continues, we won't have these regions. What we have is the starting point will be cork and the rest things will be same, and at the end pith will be crushed because of the development of the primary cortex, primary xylem. So this was the secondary growth description. Thank you.